Hi friends, welcome to our channel. This is Kishore Bharavarsa. Please subscribe our channel for more videos and more information. Please go through our channel daily as well as please support me and also please encourage to me, okay, for good information for the different types of classes. Okay, so now today we are going to discussing about HVDC links. Okay, HVDC links. Okay, so coming to the before going to discussing about HVDC links, the HVDC links which is began in 1954 between Iceland to Scotland, So the main advantage of HVDC links which is used to supply is reliable, means continuous of power supply is possible, as well as mainly per unit power cost also we can decreasing, as well as good efficiency of the system, as well as we can neglect the all those different types of losses, that is like a both coronal losses as well as like a proximity effect as well as like a skin effect, all those losses we can minimize, all those losses we can minimize with the help of all those HVDC links. Okay, so if you want to go for the EHVAC transmission system, in that there are different types of losses there. Okay, so corona losses and skin effect and proximity effect and Faraday effect, all those things is there, but in that, so there are more losses, but if you want to go for the HVDC links, that is minimum losses will be there when compared to HVAC. This is the better performance will be given, as well as very low losses when compared to the EHVAC transmission system. Okay, so coming to the HVDC links, there are different types of links is there. Okay, there are different types of links is there. In that, one is the monopolar link. And second one is the bipolar link. Okay. And third one is the homopolar link. So these are the three links which is mostly which is used in HVDC transmission system. Okay. So coming to the monopolar link. In this only we are using single conductor, that is usually negative polarity contains. So coming to the construction view of monopolar link, so we have to represent it here. So let us consider, first of all, this is the total representation of monopolar link, like this is there. Okay, so this is the one converter station and this is the one converter station. Okay, so here, so the representation of monopolar link which is given as, okay, so generally here with the help of all those things, so we can transmit to the DC power. Why we are transmit in terms of DC only, transfer in terms of AC. So if you want to transfer the total power in DC, so then only we can reduce the line losses. So that's why we can convert into the AC power supply into DC power supply with the help of different types of HVDC links. Okay. So coming to the monopolar link here. So here, so this is the one of the half of the converter. And this is the another half of the converter. Okay, this is the one of the half of the conductor, and this is the another half of the converter. Okay, so if you observe this diagram, you can clearly understood. Okay, so here, so first of all, so coming from the different types of sources. So let us consider this is like some sources here. So that is like a conventional sources, like thermal power plant or a hydro power plant or nuclear power plant. Okay, whatever may be that. So from these sources, we can generate the electrical energy. So that is usually maximum AC supply. Okay, that AC supply which is fed to the transformers. Okay, so the transformer which is used to step up the voltage. Okay, and again that voltage which is fed to the converter station. Okay, and if you after this diagram here, so here there are different types of two thyristors is there. Okay, so according to the representation of link, particular valve of the thyristors, so we can simply called as either rectifier or inverter. Okay, if you observe this
you can clearly understood. Okay, so here the thyristor, which is generally connected in front of the total DC line. So if you want to connect the thyristor valves like this, so this at this time this link is acts as like a rectifier station. This link is acts as like a rectifier station. Otherwise, if you want to connect the total thyristor circuits, so which is reverse to the total line, then only at this instant we can simply call it as inverter station. Then only simply we can call it as inverter station. Okay, so coming to the here, so the thyristor wall which is connected, so like straight line, so means the gate is straighted and with respect to the overall entire so circuit. Okay, so here, so from the whenever we are supply voltage which is given to the rectifier station, this rectifier station which is connected from AC to DC, the AC supply into DC supply, so that DC supply which is totally flowing to the entire DC line, that is DC supply which is flowing to the entire DC line. Okay, and again which is fed into the inverter station, and again which is fed into the inverter station. Okay, so this is the symbolic representation of rectifier station as well as inverter station. Okay, so when our supply is fed into the inverter station, this inverter station which is again converted to the DC supply into AC supply, DC supply into AC supply. Okay, so finally here the output of the inverter is coming generally DC supply, AC supply. This AC supply will be given to the like transformer, similarly like this here also, similarly like this what happened here also, similarly the total converter equipments also placing here also. Okay, so with the help of transformer we can step up the voltage, and again which is given to the load centers or as like either different types of various loads, like commercial loads or like industrial loads or agricultural loads, whatever may be that. So depending upon the our requirement, we are utilizing the AC supply. We are utilizing the AC supply here also. Okay, so this is the total converter station for the total link of the monopolar link. Okay, so this is actually the rectifier station, and also this link acts as a inverter station. So in this we are using only single conductor. Why we are called as single conductor? So here the two links, the one is the rectifier station and the other one is the inverter station. Both two station which is combined to each other, then only which is called as one conductor. Then only we can call it as one conductor station or one converter station. Okay, both of this is the half of the converter station, and again this is the half of the converter station. Here two processes takes place in between, internally between the two links of the converter station. Okay, so two links means two conductors here, not two links. Okay, so here link is basically we are using as negative polarity. Negative polarity of supply will be we are generally using. Why you can call it as negative polarity? So simply reason is here. So the supply, the total supply which is coming from the total rectifier to inverter. Means here the supply which is coming from right side of the converter to left side of the converter. Okay. Here the supply which is coming to the right side of the converter to left side of the converter. That's why generally we have to indicate as negative polarity. Okay. Negative polarity of supply is there for the monopolar link. Okay, monopolar link. As well as coming to the here, so both links, both conductor links, which is may contain some, which is connected like this. So which is both are, which is connected to back to back like this here also. And well as, so simply you can call it as not back to back, simply here earth is a written path. Simply we can call it as here earth is a, earth or like a water is a, we can take the written path here also. Okay, so this is the simple representation of monopolar link. As well as coming to the monopolar link, there are more advantages there because here the construction is simple when compared to the bipolar link as well as homopolar link. As well as simply maintenance is low, very low maintenance. Why? Because in this we are using very low links, only single conductor we are using, so that's why the maintenance cost is also very low. As well as cost of the conductor cost is very low. As well as simply at the same time this link we are generally using at the very low amount of voltage ratings, for low amount of voltage rating, which is the best suitable for the low amount of voltage transfer capacity, where we are occurring low voltage transfer ratings, then only we are using monopolar link. Okay, with the help of monopolar link we can transfer to the
bulk amount of voltage. Bulk amount of voltage means, so up to like either 33 kV or 66 kV or like 110 kV, like that, up to that instant we can transfer to the maximum voltage to the long distance with the help of monopolar link possible, with the help of monopolar link possible. Okay, as well as coming to the bipolar link, okay. So once again, in the monopolar link, one drawback is there. Here the continuous power supply is not possible. Here the reliability of supply is not possible in case of monopolar link. Why? Because in this we are using only single conductor. That's why if any fault is occurring on that particular line, the total interruption of power will be occurring. The total interruption of supply will be occurring of the total line. Means there is no supply will be takes place to the utilization of consumers. Okay, that is the main drawback in the monopolar link. Okay,
as well as, so coming to the another drawback is, which is used at low voltage ratings only. Okay, so we are not using at high voltage ratings only. Why? Because we are using only single conductor. Okay, so that's why, that is one of the reason. And coming to the bipolar link, okay, so the bipolar link which is make a test, okay, coming to the bipolar link here, basically the bipolar link which is may contains the, so two polarities, which is may contains the two polarity usually. So one is the positive polarity and another one is the negative polarity. One is the positive polarity and another one is the negative polarity of the conductor. Okay, so coming to the bipolar link, in this the current which is bidirectional flow, as well as, and also in this both corona losses as well as radio interference losses, is high when compared to the monopolar link, in that monopolar link. So both corona losses as well as radio interference losses is low. Why? Because so that link which is used in low voltage ratings. But if you want to go for the bipolar link which is used at high voltage rating, so that is like either 110 kV or 220 kV or like something 560 kV or 765 kV, all those different types of voltage ratings, which is maximum voltage rating, major voltage ratings, which is used at bipolar link. So that's why the losses also increasing. Okay, both current losses as well as radio interference losses. As well as coming to the skin effect, in this HVDC links, with the help of HVDC links, the skin effect is absent in this. Okay, with the help of all those links. Okay, and as well as coming to the bipolar link, so in this continuous power supply is possible. Coming to the representation, so if you want to draw the total representation, you can clearly understand. Okay, so coming to the representation of block diagram here. Okay, so representation of block diagram here. So this is very easy for the construction point. Okay, so this is the one of the thyristor wall. Okay, and this is the another thyristor wall. Okay, so here we are using basically two converters. So that's why this is the one conductor. This is the total can be called as one converter station, or also called as one conductor station. Okay, again we are using another two conductors like this only. Okay, this is the representation of bipolar link. Okay, so this is the one converter station, and here also this is the one converter station. Here the two converter station which is connect to back to back like this, and also between the two links, between the two links, some earth is a written path is there, okay, like this. Okay, so if you have after this total diagram, you can clearly say that, so what is the rectifier station, means which link is a rectifier station and which link is a inverter station. You can clearly say that here. So coming to this link, so off of this converter station, here this is acts as a rectifier station. This link has acts as a rectifier station. So that's why here the total AC supply coming from the various sources, which is boosted by the transformer, and again which is fed into the thyristor valves. Again, so here the with the help of thyristor, which is converted into the AC supply into DC supply, and again DC supply means the output of this converter is DC power. Okay, so DC power
will be goes to the throughout the entire line, and again which is fed into the in water station, and again which is fed into the in water station. Okay, so here, so this is the one conversion which takes place here. So here the power is, so if you have to this first link here, the power which is flowing from left to right, here the power which is flowing from left to right. In case of monopolaric, the power which is flowing from right to left, that is generally indicated as negative polarity, that is indicated as negative polarity. But in case of coming to the bipolar link, the power at first instant of link, the power which is flowing from left to right, the power which is flowing from left to right, so that's why we have to indicate basically positive polarity. That's why basically what indicated as positive polarity from left to right, that's why. Okay, and coming to the another half of the link converter, another half of the link converter here. Okay, so here, so if you observe this, so which is the, which station is acts as a reference station, and which is the acts as a inverter station. So here ground is there, so from this, so in front of the, so thyristor wall, some metallic ground is there, so this is not acts as a reference station. Okay, so this is the actually from the back of the anode, this is anode, this is cathode, this is gates. There are three terminals is there for the thyristor walls, already know that I think. So from the anode which is connected to the, so different type of metallic bars. Okay, so this is actually a rectifier station, so that's why, so this rectifier station, so can be supply is fed by the various sources, and again this the total AC power which is converted into DC power, the DC power which is again goes to the throughout the entire DC line, and again which is given to the inverter station, and again which is given to the inverter station. So this inverter station which is again converting from, so total DC power into AC power, that AC power which is given to the like transformers, so with the help of transformer we can boost up the voltage, boost up means like step up the voltage, that voltage which is given to the finally different types of various sources are like different types of load centers. Okay, this is the process which takes place in this half of this converter. Okay, so here the power which is generally flowing from right to left, the power which is flowing from right side to left, right to left, so that's why basically we have to indicate as negative polarity, that's why we have to basically indicate as negative polarity. So this is actually link as a like a monopolar link, this total link will be actually like a monopolar link. Okay, monopolar link. So this is the total representation of bipolar link, this is the total representation of bipolar link. So and as well as, so coming to the bipolar link, the power supply is reliable, the power supply is reliable when compared to the monopolar link. If suppose any link is damaged, continuous power generation is possible to the other side of the link, any continuous power supply is possible to the other side of the link. Okay, so that is the main advantage of bipolar link. The bipolar link is mostly we are, so generally we are mostly in the common being, most we are using bipolar link only mostly preferable. Okay, when compared to the monopolar and homopolar. Okay, so these are the bipolar link. And coming to the, so disadvantage of bipolar link, in this maintenance cost is high, when compared to the monopolar link. Why? Because in this we are using two links conductor, that's why the maintenance cost is high, as well as the cost of the converter station also increasing, the cost of the converter station is high when compared to the monopolar link. Okay, so this is the, so total drawbacks and advantages of bipolar link. Okay, and also in this, losses also very high, already know that, I think radio communication losses, radio interference losses, as well as coronal losses, is high when compared to the monopolar link. Okay, so this is the bipolar link. Okay, so next we are going to discussing about homopolar link. Okay, so coming to the homopolar link, you can simply represent it here also. So total construction is same. Okay, basically in homopolar link we have to represent as a both conductors are negative polarity according to the power flow direction, both polarities which is may contains negative polarity. How can we justify? You have to see here also. So basically coming to the construction of representation of homopolar link. Okay, first of all, so this is the thyristor wall. Okay, and also, so in the thyristor wall is there, so that is like a, see, this is like this, and then so in the thyristor wall is there here also, this is like this, and also here like this representation also is there. So this is the total entire diagram representation of a homopolar link, So this is the one of the converter station, and again which is the another one of the converter station. Okay.
So here also earth is like a return path. Here earth is also return path also there. So similar to the both monopolar link as well as bipolar link. Okay. So here, so if you are after this diagram, you can clearly say that what is the power flow directions from the circuit diagram, entire circuit diagrams. Okay. So if you after this, so here, so this is actually the rectifier station. From this, according to the symbolic representation of thyristors, this is actually the rectifier station. Already know that. So here the power supply which is flowing from this station to from this links to this side. Okay. Well, because your supply is giving similar to the both monopolar and bipolar, and again which is with the help of transformer you can boost up the voltage, and again which is gives to the convert rectifier station. This rectifier station which is converted to AC into DC, that way DC power will be flow into the entire inverter station. This inverter station which is again converted into the DC power to AC power, that AC power which is finally throughout the transformer and which is finally gives to the various load center. Okay, here if you observe this, you can clearly understood the power which is flowing from right side to left side of the converter. We have the power which is flowing right side to left side of the converter. So that's why we are basically indicated as which polarity? Negative polarity. We have to indicate as basically we have to indicate as negative polarity of the converter station. Okay, so this is one way, the negative polarity. And coming to the inner offside of the converter, this converter station. Okay, here if you observe this, so which is the which link acts as a rectifier station and which link acts as a inverter station here. So this is like a rectifier station, this is like a inverter station. You can say that like that? No, entirely wrong. So if you observe this, so this is like a rectifier station, this is like a rectifier station. Why? Because the supply which is flowing from anode to cathode to like the total DC line, and again which is coming to like this. Why? Because here in front of the thyristor wall some metallic return path is there. So that's why this link is not acts as a rectifier station. So only this converter side link is only acts as a rectifier station. Why? Because the metallic path which is connected in front of the anode, so with refer to the transformers also, so that's why this is acts as a rectifier station. So from this rectifier station again the power which is coming from the various sources and which is converted to the AC power into DC power, the total DC power which is going to the total entire DC line, and again which is fed into the inverter station, this inverter station acts as a from DC supply to AC supply, and again that AC supply or else like AC power which is fed into the throughout the entire transformer to final which is fed into the various sources are like a load centers. Okay, here also from this instant also the power which is flowing from right side of the converter to left side of the converter. Okay, right side of the converter to left side of the converter. So that's why basically we have to indicate as negative polarity. According to the like a monopolar representation. The homopolar link also may contains to the from right side to left side. Both powers are here. From right side to left side power representation. So both are negative polarities we are using in that homopolar link. So this is the basic construction total link of homopolar link. Okay. And as well coming to the advantage of homopolar link. So in this the advantage of homopolar link is here. Also we are using the maximum high voltage rating. Like bipolar link. Okay. So as well as coming to the drawbacks of homopolar links, in this mostly drawbacks is there. Because so generally in this we are using two or more links, but basic construction representation we are using only two links, but actually the homopolar link means two or more conductors. Actually for the representation we are drawing two only, but according to the construction, practical construction, we have to draw the two or more converter station. That's why the cost of the overall converter station is high when compared to the both bipolar link as well as monopolar link. Why? Because in this we are using two or more conductors as well as two or more polarities may be contains. Okay, as well as coming to the homopolar link, that is the one of the drawback. And coming to the homopolar link, in this so the losses also very high, like radio interference losses as well as corona losses also mostly very high in case of homopolar link when compared to the bipolar as well as monopolar link. Okay, as well as so for industrial purpose, if we want to transfer the power
for the bulk amount of voltage to the long distance, we have to mostly prefer to the bipolar link only, not prefer to the homopolar link. Why? Because in this converter cost is high, already bipolar link is there. Why? Because in that we are using basically two links. So that's why that is enough. If suppose any link is maybe occurring under faults, and another link is continuously power supply. So we can't go for the homopolar link. So this is not necessary. Okay. So most we are going for the bipolar link only. Okay. So this is the total entire construction representation, total working of both different types of monopolar link and bipolar link as well as homopolar link. Okay. So this is today our class, friends. So please subscribe our channel for more videos as well as for the more information of for the different types of various classes. Okay. So please support to me as well as please encourage to me. Thank you, Ananda. Thank you. I need your support. Thank you very much.